This is WPTV.
Welcome back. BlizzCon 2019 has came and went, and boy, is there a lot to talk about. From new game announcements to expansions and even a world's first Overwatch tournament preliminaries. We asked our Blizzard experts, Jonah and Ben and Andreas, to talk about these massive announcements and see what they have to say about them. So before we get into it,
right,
we can address Blizzard's apology for their reaction to the Hong Kong's protest. What do you guys know about it?
With the whole Blitzchung thing and their whole his support over that and them taking away the whole thing. I mean, it was a rash decision, I think. It was mainly just to save their ass, really. And the apologies kind of seems a little half-assed, but.
Because I know the quote is, President J. Allen Brack said, "We moved too quickly, and to make matters worse, we were too slow to talk with all of you. We didn't live up to the high standards we set for ourselves. I am sorry and accept responsibility." So you just are like.
They're just trying to, you know, calm the waters, really. Yeah. They're not really doing anything, like, heartfelt to that.
Yeah, it's definitely like a PR move. Like,
oh, yeah.
Like, I really don't know if that really comes from like a place of them actually being sorry, because I don't know, did they actually do anything to restore like his?
They gave back a certain amount of his earnings. I don't think they gave back the total amount yet, but they're just apologizing for how rash, like how quick their decision was.
Yeah.
I mean, and the president also like I saw a video of like the apology towards like the whole thing. And like the whole time, like I was just, before I even like watched the video, I just go through the comments. I was like, oh boy, I want to see what happens. And the whole time it was just like, what is he even saying sorry for? Like he basically just mentioned sorry, but he wasn't addressing this issue, you know?
So he was just saying as a PR move, but not actually, okay.
Exactly.
So it was BS publicity son.
Yeah. It was just empty, like the whole apology.
But it's not going to stop anyone from playing the game.
Exactly.
Yeah. So it's not going to stop anyone.
There were a lot of announcements made. What was like you guys' favorite?
I personally really enjoyed the new Diablo trailer. Oh,
I'm in love with that.
Yeah, it's so good.
Did you guys play Diablo like beforehand?
Oh,
yes.
I played the third one. I never played the first and two and the second one.
I've played the first two, but only on older copies that my stepdad has owned, and oh, the graphics have changed. but even three was amazing, and I'm just super excited for four. Like the whole thing with like Lilith. And now, like, it definitely looks darker, too.
I know I read somewhere that they're going back to Diablo's original art scheme, because Diablo 3 took a more colorful approach.
Yeah.
And the new, like, Diablo 4 is supposed to go back to the original dark and gritty kind.
And I like that, too, because, I mean, it's showing what it's supposed to be. I mean, Diablo's in the name. I mean, it's supposed to be dark. It's supposed to be bad.
I mean, if you really see the cinematic, like, trailer, like, it looks, like, you can already see from the beginning, like, it's like, oh, this is going to be good. Like, it felt like a movie when I was watching the trailer. Like, it didn't feel like a game. Like, it actually felt like I was in a scene of, like, a horror movie. And, it, like, that's towards the end, good. like you just see towards the end, like, it's just a big surprise of, like, what you're going to see.
So, yeah, heck yeah. I know I haven't played the Diablo series, but that is one I'm interested in, especially since it looks like a horror movie. But
absolutely, yeah.
Another announcement was Overwatch 2.
Yes.
That was announced. And that seems to be... It's supposed to even have like a story-driven plot and new characters and everything. Like, what are you guys' thoughts about that?
Well, personally, I mean, the story of Overwatch is my favorite thing about Overwatch. I mean, I love all like the different, like the competitive teams and like that whole thing. But the story of Overwatch, like they do explore it a little bit in like the current game for Overwatch, like through like special events and stuff like that. But to really like dive deep into that in a story mode, I'm super, super, super excited for. And I'm very excited to see like the new characters.
Yeah.
I mean, I like the whole cinematic thing that they do with it and the, how they turn it. It's almost like watching like an animated show because they have one for like every character, multiple for every character.
The one that I loved was May, I think.
Yeah, and I like it. I'm kind of checked out with the Overwatch 2. Like, when I first saw that, like, what do they need to make a second one for? Because all they really do is add more characters and then do that. But with the story, I mean, Blizzard does a good job with that, so they might do well with it.
Mm. All right, well, for me, like, the storytelling, like, I'm just excited for the story itself because I just want to know where, like, it goes through, like, where this takes. But I also want to just talk about like the characters.
Aside from the characters, what do you guys think about like the new ones?
Like, but for me, I like the design. Like, okay. I just love the new design. Like, you could tell the little details, and I feel like they really do matter. Like, they really do change a little bit of the game. Like, they give you a different like look on how they're gonna, you know, like they're better. Like, how do I put it? It just give a different output of how the character is gonna be now.
Gotcha.
It adds a new dynamic to the entire like thing. Because each time they add a new character, it always changes the game in some way. You have to play it differently every time they add a new character.
Oh yeah, because it's like a whole nother in like the. When you're in the battles, I don't know the words, I'm bad at the words.
Yeah, matches.
When you're in the matches, you have a whole new character that has a whole new special abilities that you have to learn to protect against, or if you're going to play them, like mastering them, which I really like that mechanic, because then you can always do something new. Are there any new characters you're excited about?
I thought that robotic one, I can't remember the name of it. It was like a weird one. It was like flying, I don't know. It looked weird, but I thought the design of it was cool, but you don't exactly see, you didn't exactly see anything like too much about what they can do or like what their role would be and what their powers are. So I think that's something to look more towards in the future of what they're going to release about it and different things coming up.
Going back to Diablo 3, one of the things that you guys talked about was a cinematic approach. Do you think they need to make changes from like the old ones? I know they're doing cinematic approach now. Do you think the old ones also reflected that?
I think they do. Blizzard does heavy cinematic stuff. I relate it back to StarCraft because that's what I really played a lot of, and everything in there is like a cinematic thing. In between each story mode, like story campaign mission, there's a cinematic trailer. Like there's something going on there to aid it. And I mean, it looks great, and like that's like Diablo right there, and the same animation they give to all other games. But the cinematic portion of it is like more—it's more of an entertainment outside of the actual game. It's more of like seeing it. I've always said that they should make a movie on it because it would turn out well, and they have enough money for it. I would think.
Definitely.
All in all, what did you think of BlizzCon 2019?
A lot of cool announcements. It's going to be a long wait, definitely for Diablo at least. They threw a lot at us. It was a lot. It was like it was just like okay, and here's everything.
Yeah.
I think maybe it was another PR move to maybe make up for things. But
I mean, it's a lot of announcements. It's a lot of things to put on it, and that I mean, clearly they've started production on a lot of things in advance. But I mean, that's a lot of things to be working on at the same time. Yeah. So, I mean, I know they're gonna probably do well with it because they haven't really had a bad thing in a while. Like even Hearthstone, one of their smaller things, it gets
it's
a lot
been
of
doing. Okay, stay tuned because up next we take a look at Obsidian Entertainment's brand new game, Outer Worlds, and my own spin-off of Press Start Plays, Miss Game and Talk. We'll see just what makes this game so big.